Hello, this is Alex with a very short and simple Lightroom video today. I just want to show one technique, and that's addressing this overexposed blob of sun that's just slightly behind the clouds here. I included the sun in the frame because I like how it casts this warm light onto these rocks, but ultimately the composition is a bit too busy for my taste. I do not like this gray part of the clouds here. There's just too much going on in that frame, and that's not a good balance. But it can still serve as an example for this technique, because we can reduce the overexposed area and how harsh it looks with negative dehaze. For that, I bring up my masking panel, and you see I already have a mask here in place for the foreground. And I create a new mask, and I use the radial gradient tool here, which allows us to make round shaped selections. I pull this over the sun here. Maybe I adjust the angle slightly like this, and make it a little bit bigger even. And I want a nice large feathering here, so I have a soft transition. And then I use negative dehaze. And to start with, I pull that slider all the way to minus 100. And you see how this white blob of sun almost entirely disappears. It's just very vaguely visible here. And of course, that's too much. Let's hide the edit pins here so that I get a clear view of this area now. And then I pull that negative dehaze back until the sun begins to reappear. Maybe that's here. That's a good value, I think. It still connects to the reflection down here, but it is rendered much softer. What I can add to this effect is perhaps a little bit of warming of this area by using the temperature adjustment. You see, this adds a nice warm glow around the sun. Of course, this is too much, so I use the same approach and just dialed it back until it looks more convincing. That's a good value. Maybe I want to adjust the tint a little bit more, go into the purple or into the green. I'm not sure. Doesn't seem to have a good effect. So I'll leave that alone, but it's always worth playing. What I could also play with to soften this area would be to use negative clarity or negative texture. If I do that, you see here, it doesn't have that much effect. So I just leave that alone, but it's always worth trying these sliders when you want to create an area that is a little bit softer. Now, if we look at the connection here to the reflection, that looks a little bit hard. I can simply expand this mask, add to it, and include this area of the reflection on the water. For this, I use a brush. My brush settings are always with a very large feather and a low flow. The size is good to adjust this area here. And then I go over these overexposed spots in the reflection and just brush that effect in very gently to also create a softer look and a little bit of glow. Add that to those rocks down here too, because I think that looks really good, especially with the warming. I don't want to have that in the wave here, so maybe I need to activate my overlay and press my Option or Alt key to switch to the erase brush. Just take that out here with a very small brush, like so. Deactivate my overlay. And I can do a before and after now. I click on that little eye symbol here. When I click and hold, it turns that temporarily off. And you see here's the hard rendition of the overexposed sun. And with my mask applied, it's much softer. The warming helps a lot, makes that more plausible and all in all more pleasing. Close my masking panel. That's all for today. I hope you like this technique. Thanks for watching.